little break. I'm student nurse Adusei from Asanta Western Nursing Training College, and I'm here to give a summary of cerebrovascular accidents. Cerebrovascular accidents occurs when there is an obstruction in that fluid to the brain cells, resulting in death of the brain cells. Some risk factors are age above 65 years, women with contraceptive medication, diabetic patients, cardiovascular conditions, kidney diseases are all at risk of developing cerebrovascular accidents. There are three major causes. We have thrombotic stroke. It occurs when there is an occlusion buildup in blood vessels. And also we have embolic. Embolic stroke occurs when there is a moving clot. Moving clot, this clot will develop in any of the blood vessels and could move and occlude in the cerebral blood vessel, resulting in cerebrovascular accidents. We also have hemorrhagic stroke. It occurs when there is rupture of the cerebral blood vessels. Signs and symptoms: there could be numbness, confusion, and then there could be vision impairment, speech deficits, and visual impairment. Confusion too can result from cerebrovascular accidents. I'll talk about pathophysiology. The disease condition comes about when there is obstruction of that flow to the brain cells. The brain depends on constant supply of glucose and oxygen-rich blood for its functioning. So when this supply is cut or it's impaired, the brain suffers from ischemia and then results in the death of the brain cells. Diagnostic investigations: we have CT scan, also known as computed tomography scan, angiographies, magnetic resonance imaging, and then electrocardiogram to confirm diagnosis of the condition. I'd like to talk about the treatment plan for this condition. For the treatment plan, we are giving thrombohemolytic agents. These agents will dissolve all the existing clot in the blood vessels, and then antiplatelets too will prevent clot formations in our blood vessels. And then we are also giving anticoagulants. This anticoagulant will prolong clotting time. And then we also give statins, being atorvastatin or pyrovastatin. These statins will reduce cholesterol level of our patients. And we also give antihypertensive medications like calcium channel blockers, beta blockers, to reduce the blood pressure of our patients. We also give osmotic diuretics and mannitol, furosemide, to patients with intracranial hemorrhages. Complications of this condition: cerebrovascular accidents could result in total paralysis of our patients, or it could also result in unstable blood pressure, fluid volume imbalance, and then there could be sensory impairment, visual impairment, speech deficits, and many others. With the prevention or education, I would like to treat all patients diagnosed of chronic conditions like diabetes and hypertension, to adhere strictly to their treatment regimen.